Good evening, my dear young students. Today, I would like to tell you about few things that you tell to yourself every day so that you can achieve your goals. And so these things you must always remember. So the first thing is always think, and today will be my day. Today I'll get what I want in what I want. So for example, in the morning you make a list of things to do, you make an agenda for today, you make what is to be read, how it has to be read. By the end of the day you will get it and you will achieve what you wrote in the morning, what you said in the morning. So always think in that way. That is, today will be the my day. Today will be the my day. Please, that is the first thing. Second thing, I am loved. Love is eternal bond. So think that you are being loved by your parents, your close kith and kin, your friends. So you are not inferior to anybody, and you can be loved. And so always think, I am loved. So then the next thing you must know is, I am more than my appearance. Some students feel that they are neither beautiful nor handsome, but don't think like that. So you are more than your appearance, and feel like that, you can do in a better way. When you are feeling that you are not smart looking, you are not good looking, you are not beautiful, you are not handsome, that may hinder in achieving your goals. That may block your way of achieving your goal. Always feel that you are more than your appearance. So that's why you always think that I am more than my appearance. I am more than my appearance. I am more than my appearance. And remember, I deserve respect. Respect is earned. Respect is not by demand. So because of your actions, and people will respect you. People will give respect. So always feel that, always think that, by my actions I deserve respect, I get respect. Since respect is by earning, not by demand. So always think that I deserve respect. So always think, I am strong. I am not inferior to anybody. I am equally competent to get what I want in my life. Such a potential energy I have. Such a tremendous energy levels I have. And I can get what I want. So I feel strong. I feel intelligent. I am strong. So I am not inferior to anybody. So I can get what I want. I can achieve what I want. See, my immediate goal is how to face the coming NEET final examination. That will be held on 26th July. So definitely, I can face that exam. I can write that exam very well. I will get a good rank. That will make a way for me to enter in the medical college by getting admission in MBBS. You are strong. So always think that I am strong. And very important point, I am in charge of my life. I am in charge of my life. No one is in charge of your life. Yat bhavam tat bhavate. Your life is what your thoughts make it. And you are the in charge of your life. Your actions will make you to lead your life only. So always think that you are in charge of your life. Your actions make your personality. Your words make your thinking process. Your thinking will make you to do particular thing. So that means thoughts will become actions. Actions will become habits. Habits will become your character. So you are the in charge of your life. No one is the in charge of your life. We only guide you. We only motivate you. We only inspire you. But ultimate person is you, whether you listen to us, whether you do what we say, and all those things will be done by you only. So you are the in charge of your life, then, and everything that happens to me gives a valuable lesson. Think like that, so that you will overcome from the failure result. In one weekend examination, you get less marks. Don't bother. Don't get depressed. Don't get frustrated. And you think that everything that happens to me in life gives a valuable lesson to me. By doing so many mistakes in this particular examination, I learned new things. If this question is asked in this way, how I will solve this question? How I will get an answer to this question? I have learned those two aspects. If the same question will be appeared in the final examination, I will not make that mistake. In that way, I am being benefited. That is the lesson I learned from this incident. Always think that whatever happens to me, that gives a valuable lesson to me. That's most important nowadays. So with an expectation, you go to the examination center. Every day you are writing this test or this test, whatever it may be. Maybe a grand test, maybe a part test. When you are writing a grand test before entering in the examination hall or before starting your examination, you are under impression that you may get 180 out of 180 in botany or 170 of 180. But when you get 130 or 140, don't get discouraged. Where and introspect where you made mistakes, where you made the mistakes. Is it due to the lack of the understanding of the particular concept? If it is so, how can I learn that? By doing that mistake, I learned this new aspect. In that way, I am being benefited. And think like that. That is, whatever happens to me in my life, from that incident, I learn a new thing. I learn a valuable lesson. That you should always think like that. And remember, my past does not define my present or my future. Very important aspect. So whatever happened in the past, that cannot make the things happen now, or that will not define your future course of action. So whatever happened is happened, forget it. If it is a good thing, enjoy it as a memory. If it is a bad thing, get a lesson from that past and don't repeat that. That's all. Whatever happened is happened. Past is past. And think that past never define either present or future. Past neither defines today or tomorrow, not tomorrow. Think like that. Then, and remember, very important point. So everyone's journey is different. Every person is unique. That's why a great philosopher once said, Emerson said, everybody is a great person. There is something to be learned from every person. What a great statement is that. Great philosopher Emerson said like that. So everybody's journey is different. My journey is in this way. That fellow's journey is on that way. So doesn't matter. Everybody's journey is different. Now the 10th point is, things always get better with time. So some unhappy incident happened. So that you cannot change. An event that happened cannot be changed. So for example, a measurable event. For example, just before examination, somebody gets malaria and typhoid. What can we do? It is an unavoidable threat. We can take medicines. We can go to the examination hall after taking medicine. So that disease may influence. So it may influence us in that way. That is, you may not be able to write exam properly. So that is not in our hands. So today, COVID-19, nobody expected, but as time passes, so that things will be better. So that is there everywhere, in every sphere of life, in every part of life. As the time passes, things will be better. You think like that, then and the happiness is found within us. Dalai Lama said like that, Buddha said like that, anybody says like that only. So that is, happiness is within us only. It is a state of feeling, and don't search happiness somewhere else. Happiness is in you only. Always think positively. Always be happy. Happiness is not somewhere else. Happiness is within you only. And so it is, so then I choose to see the good in people I interact with today. And remember, I choose to see the good in the people I interact with today, and develop a habit of seeing good in people to whom you are interacting. So don't think all people are alike, all people behavior is similar. So there are different kinds of people. There are different kinds of people with different attitudes, and there are critics. There are people who praise you. There are people who always think in a negative way, who always criticizes you. But even in from them also, try to see the good. And if there is any good point in their behavior, in their actions, learn from them. And so always see good to the people to whom you are interacting. And the last 13th point is, feel that world needs you. World needs you. World needs you. So one of my student, and a decade back, now who completed MS and doing PG, and Preetam is watching now, and and world needs him. That is the last one. That's why I quoted his example. World needs him because he completed MBBS, he completed MS, and he's doing final year specialty in that is MCH. And so world needs him. He will be the most expert man in robot surgery, and tomorrow he will become the most important person. And so in the society, his services are needed. So like that, think like that, world needs me, world needs me. So always think that world needs you. And by observing these 13 principles or 13 guidelines or 13 points, you will be the most happy students, and you will get whatever you want in your life. All the best. Good night.